Good evening. Thank you for joining us. We will get started in just a moment. Good evening and thank you for joining us this evening. We would like to welcome you to Myers Park High School Rising Freshmen and New to CMS event. We have a great evening planned for you this evening. First off, we're going to start with three videos that come from our electives department. One is from our performing arts department and it's going to be our mixed chamber choir performing. The second one is from our junior ROTC department and it's going to be a video for them. And then the last one is going to again be from our performing arts department, and that is going to be a dance video. We hope you will enjoy them.
Let my people go down. Welcome to the Mustang Battalion, where you can be a part of a community outside the four walls of your school. The main focus in the classroom is to teach and develop lifelong skills with the goal of building high graduates who are prepared for life after high school. If you're seeking a mental, physical, or academic challenge, you can join any of our seven teams, which is Drill, Color Guard, Book Study, J-Lab, Raiders, Orienteering, and Rifle. Be a part of our bigger community by meeting people of all ages, from school visits to graduations, senior living homes, and parades. You'll be able to do it all. You can participate in different events from summer programs to school-hosted events, which are basketball, volleyball, field day, and more. Don't forget to show your school spirit by wearing your Mustang Battalion gear and supporting the teams through their challenges and events. Always know that there is a team of leaders ready to support you and guide you.
Hi, future Mustangs. My name is Yasmeen Tarleton, and I'm the dance teacher here at Myers Park High School. I wanted to invite you to sign up for a dance class here at Myers Park. I teach a variety of dance genres, and we have beginning all the way to advanced. If you have prior dance experience and want to audition for an upper-level class, go to the website listed below, and we can schedule an audition prior to next year. And I look forward to having you in one of my classes.
So this is only a sampling of the talent that we have on our campus among our teachers and our students. We're very excited to have you learn more about what's available through our performing arts programs and our visual arts programs, junior ROTC, our health and PE department, CTE department. So we're very glad that you're here this evening. Next up is going to be Principal Mark Bosco. And we're very excited that he's going to be talking about our vision, school mission and vision this evening.
Good evening, families. Welcome to our Rising Freshmen event. I have to say, you know, these are strange times. Normally we'd be meeting at school and we'd be in our auditorium and you'd be able to experience, you know, our various art programs live. And, I think when you saw that first clip that had our mixed chamber, you just get a sense of the flexibility and creativity that we've had to employ to keep kids engaged in these times. I am gonna talk about, you know, our goals and what I feel that we've been working towards at Myers Park. This is my eighth year there, but I do want you all to know that we do hope that we are gonna get to a place where, you know, the beginning of next school year, we're gonna be returning to, you know, everyone in class, without these necessary rotations and partial use, but we're gonna see. It has been an absolute focus for us for the past year, and I'm happy to say we have kids back at school finally after a year. We've just finished our second week with live instruction, and it's going fantastic. The teachers have done a great job. Staff's done a great job preparing, and the kids have just been delightful. What I do want to talk about is, under normal times, what are we trying to do at Myers Park? And, you know, really it boils down to two things. We focus on high academic achievement for all students, and we want to do that while cultivating a sense of family. Culture is very important to me, making sure that large feels small, that there's a focus on customer service. In many ways, Myers Park, the largest high school in North Carolina, is organized like a community college, with each building kind of representing a content area or focus. Having said that, though, there's nothing that would stand in the way of folks receiving ultimate customer service and care. And that's our goal, is that high academic achievement for all students while cultivating a sense of family. Within that, we have a mantra. A mantra, it's like a phrase or a saying that staff and students have embraced over the years, and it's the park, make it your own. The idea is, no matter what you look like, where you're from, what's your zip code, doesn't matter. You have a place at Myers Park. As long as you're willing to come to school and share part of yourself with us, there's a place for you there. The power of Myers Park is its diversity. We pull from the wealthiest communities in Charlotte and the poorest. And within that, you've got all sorts of different socioeconomics, different race and ethnicity, experience, and all of that comes together at the school. And yeah, there probably are stereotypes about what the school is like, but until you go to the school and see what it's like, those stereotypes do not ring true. It is an amazingly diverse place, full of diverse people, but also diverse program. The way I like to describe it is, it's the Myers Park mosaic. And if you know what a mosaic is, it's a picture. And it's a picture made up of many small tiles. And just like a mosaic is made up of very, very small individual tiles, the Myers Park experience is also made up of these small little mosaic pieces that can represent a person or experience or a program. And so, you know, when you come to Myers Park, there are so many choices, whether it's sports, extracurriculars, academic programs like IB, AP, College and Career Promise, CTE, a specialization in the arts. There is just something for everyone. And I do want to say this. Some folks think that we're mainly focused on the high flyers. And I'm here to tell you that's not necessarily true. While we are focused on the high flyers, we are also interested in ensuring that the resources of the Myers Park community are available to all. And so we really are concerned with meeting kids that are at risk, and being at risk, that could be from any background. And we understand that, but we want to stand ready to support any student and family that may be in need. Lastly, I'll just talk a little bit about my philosophy. I'm in my 27th year as an educator. I love Myers Park. It is a sweet spot for me. It's perfect for my style of leadership and my desire to be creative with resources. It's a vibrant community that really wraps itself around all kids. And there are three cornerstones of my philosophy. One is to be student-centered, meaning that everything we do has to be about kids, has to be about students. The second part of my philosophy revolves around what I call utility, meaning what's going to provide the greatest possible benefit for the greatest number. And then lastly, fidelity. Whatever you do, do it the best that you can and at a high level. Otherwise, just don't bother. So what I've highlighted today, a little bit about what we're trying to do as far as goals, the mantra, and a little bit about my philosophy. And, you know, we've got a lot more to share. Do want I lift up that the initial arts programs that were featured in the JRTC program, some of the parts of the video, I do want you to recognize that was pre-COVID, some of those picks, so that's why they weren't wearing masks. We are absolutely focused right now on COVID-19 protocols. We teach kids the three W's, which is wear, wash, and wait. Wear a mask, wash your hands, social distance, and wait. So this is part of our reality right now. And while, I want to talk about my philosophy and And what I'm trying to do at the school long term, you know, for the past year, it has really been focused on trying to mitigate the impact of COVID-19. And I know that's on a lot of people's minds, but we're working on it and we'll continue as we move forward. And I'm just very hopeful for the future. So thank you for this time. I'll turn it back over to Ms. Davis.
Thank you, Mr. Bosco. So again, I'm Allison Davis. I'm the Assistant Principal of Instruction. So I get the opportunity to work closely with Mr. Bosco in planning our instructional program at Myers Park High School. So I'm gonna talk a little bit this evening just about some of the pathways that we have available for students. Again, as Mr. Bosco mentioned, we try to make sure that we have a place for every student here on our campus. So we have a scholars program, an honors program, an advanced placement program, and then an NYP and DP International Baccalaureate program, which Ms. Willett will share more about in just a few minutes. Next slide, please. So scholars level program, what we have found to be the case is many students have a hard time transitioning from middle school where they get to have subjects year long. To high school level, where now what we have is we have courses that run 4x4, which means they meet every day for an entire semester, and courses that run A day, B day, which means that they run every other day for the entire school year. So what some students find is that to transition from where they maybe had math or English all year long, or even a foreign language all year long, to now having it only for a semester every day and then having that gap in there is difficult for them. So what we do offer to students is we offer them Foundations of Math 1 and Math 1, which is a year-long math, or if they happen to have already earned their Math 1 credit, we also have Foundations of Math 2 and Math 2, which is a year-long course. That allows the students to have math every day for the entire year, which makes a better transition. We offer the same opportunity in English. So basically a student who would be in our scholars level program would take the year-long math, the year-long English, which would be four of their credits, Earth and Environmental Science, NYP Economic and Personal Finance, NYP Health and PE, and then they would have space for one additional elective. Now do note that NYP Economic and Personal Finance and NYP Health and PE is a middle years IB program course that Ms. Willett's going to talk a little bit more about. What we have been trying to do is provide this opportunity for every student on our campus and give them an opportunity to transition into NYP and honors level classes with the support of teachers. And then from there, what our goal is to have them to consider going into more honors and AP courses or NYP and IB courses. So again, every student, regardless of which program they pick, will take NYP Economic and Personal Finance, which is their social studies course, and NYP Health and PE. Next slide. For those that are interested in an honors level course, again, the math may be a year-long math. And in addition to that, they could take a year-long English, or if they've already taken their Math 1 credit, they may take Honors Math 2 or Honors Math 3, depending on whether they've already earned the Math 2 credit. We also offer Honors English 1. In addition to that, we have Honors Earth and Environmental Science, again, the social studies requirement, the health and PE requirement, and then in that case, they could have from 1 to 3 elective spaces available to them to give them their 8 credits for that particular school year. Next slide, please. From there, we do have some students that are ready to start AP courses. So in the 9th grade, we do offer to students the opportunity to take AP Computer Science Principles. There is no math requirement for that, and that is the one AP course that is available on the 9th grade card. However, we do have some students who will come to us from the Horizons program, which is from Randolph, and because of where they are placed, they will occasionally have to have another AP course because that's automatically the next step and they have the prerequisites for that. I will point out, brand new to us this upcoming school year, which we're very excited about, is we are now introducing the AP Capstone Diploma program. In order to earn the AP Capstone Diploma, a student must take 6 AP courses across their 4 years at Myers Park. Of those 6 courses, one must be AP Seminar, and one must be AP Research, And then they must score a 3 or higher on all 6 courses. They can take more than 6, but it's a minimum of 6 that includes the seminar and the research. Thank you. Next slide. Next up, I'm happy to introduce Katie Willett, who is our IB International Baccalaureate Coordinator, and she's going to talk a little bit more about the MYP and DPIB program.
Good evening, everyone. I'm Katie Willett, as Ms. Davis introduced, and I lead our MYP and our DPIB programs. Next slide. So we have our middle years program, which we throw around a lot of acronyms in IB. So MYP stands for our middle years program, and that is for our 9th and 10th grade students. And this is really designed for students age 11 to 16, and it provides a framework of learning that encourages students to become creative, critical, and reflective thinkers. The MYP emphasizes intellectual challenge, encourages students to make connections between their studies in their traditional subjects and the real world, and it fosters a development of skills for communication, intercultural understanding, and global engagement, which, of course, we believe are essential qualities for our young people who are becoming our global leaders. Students participate in a program, and I'll explain a little bit more of what those requirements are, and they have the opportunity to earn an MYP certificate. In addition, the MYP program prepares students to enter into the diploma program, which is for our 11th and 12th grade students. This is a 2-year international education program that prepares students that roughly between 16 and 19 years of age for success going into and throughout university. Our DP offers a holistic approach to teaching and learning with a keen focus on developing intercultural awareness, and students learn to explore and understand the world through inquiry, critical thinking, and open-mindedness. And students have the opportunity to work towards the IB diploma, which is in addition to their Myers-Park High School diploma, as well as earning potential college university credits per course what they take. Next slide, please. Perfect. Thank you. So in 1992, Myers-Park High School became the first public school in North Carolina to offer the IB diploma program and the first school, public or private, to offer the IB middle years program. So we're very proud of that long legacy that we have. This is just a quick reminder that 9th and 10th grade students are in the MYP and our 11th and 12th grade students are in the DP. And as a school, we have an open enrollment for both programs as long as you are zoned for our attendance area. And so as Ms. Davis talked about, we really want to provide opportunities, and that is why we are offering the MYP personal finance and MYP health and PE to our freshmen coming in. So this is just a reminder that the IB programs are skill building programs that focus on college readiness as well as developing well-rounded students. And again, those MYP students work towards that MYP certificate and our DP working towards that IB diploma and possible university credit. Next slide, please. So in general, the IB high school experience is a traditional high school experience with a rigorous academic schedule. Our students are fully Myers-Park High School students, so they are encouraged to get involved in student life activities such as band, choir, sports, clubs, theater, student organizations, you name it, we want them involved. Really what Mr. Bosco is saying, we want them to make the park their own. In our middle years program, students, in addition to their studies, complete the services action, and that is a community interaction component. So they go out, they interact, they meet some of the requirements that we have for that. And in the 10th grade, students complete the personal project. And this is where students explore an area of personal interest that allows them to develop and refine their learning skills through research and writing. Should students decide to go into the diploma program, this is again for their 11th and 12th grade, they will take the courses required towards the IB diploma. And they will also take a theory of knowledge class, which is where students reflect on the nature of knowledge and how we know what we claim to know. It's quite an interesting course if you ever get to drop in on it. And they also participate in the extended essay, and their community involvement is referred to as creativity, activity, and service. And those are those components of that program. Next slide, please. So on the right-hand side, you will see what the IB has as a curriculum model. And so in the center, we always keep that learner profile at the center, keeping our learners there. And that is a school-wide learner profile that we have at Myers-Park High School. Surrounding that, you will see the different subject groups that students take. And this is again where students have opportunities to develop that knowledge, attitudes, and skills that they need to manage complexity and take responsible action in the future. It ensures a breadth and depth of understanding through study in 7 subject groups. It requires the study of a world language to support the understanding of our own cultures and those of others. And it empowers those students to participate in that service as action throughout the community. And of course, we do encourage personal and academic growth through the personal project. Next slide. So this is our guide to recommended coursework. Just in brief, MYP students take courses in 7 subject areas. They complete a personal project. They participate in services action, which is that community involvement. And again, we have their coursework set up to prepare them should they wish to enter into the diploma program their 11th and 12th grade year. On the website, you will find this whole document, which gives an annotated approach to how to enroll and what classes to enroll in, very similar to what Ms. Davis talked about. It aligns with our Myers-Park courses. And so you can find this and it will walk you through. There's also a recording where I walk students through what courses to sign up for, et cetera, on the website too, which is a great resource, I think. Next slide, please. And next slide. And so these are the questions that I often ask students and parents as they're considering if the IB is right for them. And so these are just the questions just to think through, reflect on as you consider joining and coming with us into the full MYP and or DP eventually. So how do I respond when challenged? Can I handle rigor, time management, and balance responsibilities? Am I able to self-advocate and seek help and assistance when needed? What are my goals for the future? And then the most important one is, what is my why? Why am I interested in this program? And again, I can help you talk through those. Our website has a lot of resources as well. Next slide. And so again, just to recap, you can find this. Our IB website is myersparkib.org. Again, our 9th and 10th grade is MYP. Our 11th and 12th grade is DP. On our website, you will find the guide to recommended coursework for each grade level and program, the requirements for each program, and specific grade level information. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Ms. Willett. And one of the questions that we will often get is, how do you apply for the MYP and DP diploma program and the IB program? And so just to remind you that you do not have to complete a special application process. You just select the courses when it's time to select your courses. However, we are not a magnet school, so you do have to be zoned for Myers-Park in order to enroll in the program. Next up, I would like to introduce Joanne Pugsley. Joanne Pugsley is the Career and Development Coordinator for our Career and Technical Education program. She does an amazing job wearing a lot of hats. She oversees our North Carolina High School Athletic Association. Our North Carolina Virtual Public Schools program. She also oversees our CPCC program. And then she serves as one of the co-department chairs for Career and Technical Education. So thank you, Ms. Pugsley, for being here this evening.
Thank you, Ms. Davis. Welcome, everyone. Again, my name is Joanne Pugsley. I am the Career Development Coordinator for Myers-Park. I do have two other staff members at Myers-Park that assist me with these responsibilities to oversee the Career and Technical Education Department, otherwise known as CTE for short. Mr. Andy Dowds is the Pathway Development Coordinator and Damond Wilson is our Instructional Facilitator. We have very specialized programs in CTE, so it requires a lot of oversight to make sure that everything happens like it needs to, and we can provide great programs for our Myers-Park High School students. We have 8 curriculum areas where you can take specialized courses. These are usually put in elective spots after your core courses or required high school graduation requirements are satisfied. We have classes in automotive, business, biomedical science, computer science, culinary arts, engineering, interior design, and marketing. Many of our curriculum areas have industry certifications that students earn that actually are very well respected in looking for entry-level jobs. So this is something that you may want to consider. We have more details on our bit.ly, www.bit.ly/CTEmagic. So you can get a lot more specific information about the actual courses that are offered for each one of these specialized curriculum areas. Next slide, please. I also oversee the Career and College Promise program. This is something that is open to juniors and seniors in high school. So although our incoming freshman class won't be taking advantage of this program right away, there are some things that you will need to know in order to qualify for the program if it interests you as you go forward. You do have to have an unweighted GPA of 2.8. So it's important that students academically perform well their first 3 semesters at Myers-Park to qualify for the program. In order to start the program in the fall of your junior year, you will be applying as a sophomore in the spring. Our current sophomores are already putting in their applications. So again, you only have 3 semesters to maintain that needed GPA to get into the program. And that is really the only academic qualification. Why would you take classes at CPCC? There's great opportunities there. It's a way to expand our Myers-Park High School opportunities for you. We have elective options that you can take at CPCC that Myers-Park doesn't offer. We can't offer everything. Students earn transferable college credit if you take a college transfer course at CPCC and earn a C or higher. That is transferable to most public universities throughout the country, and they've already been vetted in North Carolina universities as well. Also, this program is free. Tuition and fees are waived for high school students while they're taking classes at CPCC. There are 5 different college transfer programs, and there are over 50 technical programs that you can participate in at CPCC. You can earn your associate's degree in the college transfer pathway, or you can earn an applied associate's degree as well. This is not a requirement of the program. You can do anything from take one class a semester to supplement your Myers Park High School schedule to taking 100% of your classes at CPCC and working towards that associate's degree. Next slide. I also oversee the North Carolina Virtual Public High School. This is when you take classes that are online, and they can be done for a variety of reasons. We might want to supplement your Myers Park High School schedule with courses that currently don't fit. We have situations where you might want to participate in the IB diploma program, and in order to qualify for that, there are a certain set of classes that you need to take before your junior year. In order to fit those all in, we might need to do something online. We also have classes that are available to us through North Carolina Virtual Public High School that we don't offer at Myers Park, such as Japanese. NCVPS is also offering sign language, which is becoming popular, that we don't offer at Myers Park. Some students have a goal to graduate from high school early, so this is a way to fit in a couple of more classes while you're taking your high school courses. We also have students who want to expedite some of their high school graduation requirements. They can be at CPCC full-time their junior and senior year. And then there can be other reasons that, that run the gamut from medical, traveling, being involved in high-level sports activities, a gamut of reasons of why this just might be a good fit for you for a semester or for a particular course. You do need to speak with your school counselor to enroll in an online class. I do not oversee that. So if your counselor approves that you can take one of these courses, then you'll meet with me and I'll make sure that the registration and all of that goes through properly.
Thank you so much, Ms. Pugsley. So in addition to getting to work closely with Mr. Bosco planning our instructional program, I also get to work with the entire counseling department, which is an absolute privilege. We have 9 counselors, soon to be 10 counselors, and you will not find any better counselors anywhere in North Carolina, the United States, any place. Ours are super devoted to our students, and we're so grateful for them. So next I'm going to introduce Sandra Kendall and Amber Dowdy, who are our co-chairs for our counseling department.
Hello, my name is Sandra Kendall and I am one of the co-chairs, and Amber, I don't see her.
Hi, I'm Amber Dowdy. I am the other co-chair with Ms. Kendall.
So we're going to talk to you a little bit about course registration and talk about some graduation requirements. A lot of the things we've already gone over as far as the specifics of the curriculum, but we just wanted to let you know that the counselors will be coming to middle schools beginning next week. And then we will have our non-CMS days on the 23rd and the 24th, if I'm not mistaken, Ms. Dowdy.
Correct.
23rd and the 24th. And as Mr. Bosco said, these are strange times, so we have to do that a little bit differently this year. Actually sent out registration forms, and we'll be sending them to the non-CMS schools next week, but we sent out registration forms, PowerPoints, and a whole lot of resources to kind of help you guys prepare for the actual registration. Next slide, please. So graduation requirements. So a student needs 4 English credits. It doesn't matter if it's AP, IB, as long as it's an English class, and they are expected to take an English class every year of high school. A student needs 4 math credits to graduate from high school, and it depends on your curriculum on what math you're going to take. Of course, we have the 4 social studies credits, and as Ms. Davis said, every freshman who's coming in is going to take that IB personal finance and economics class. 3 science credits, and that's earth and environmental science, biology and physical science, as well as you may choose between 2 of these, to CTE credits, to art credits, or to world language credits. And you do not need world language credits to graduate from high school, but if you're planning to go to a four-year university, you want your child to go to a four-year university, they need to sign up for a language class. And of course, the dreaded health and PE. We have a lot of students, everybody needs to have that, or they will not get a high school diploma that is required by the state of North Carolina. And then of course, there's 6 elective credits. Next slide, please.
So one of the things that students need to know, particularly middle school students who are transitioning to high school, is you are promoted in high school based on the number of credits you receive. So if you are looking to be promoted to a 10th grade student, you would need to have 6 credits. And so thinking about that, remember you are taking 8 classes a year. From 10th to 11th grade, you need 12 credits. Those credits though must include English 1, English 2, and Math 1. So to go from 10th to 11th, those 12 credits must have those 3 specific ones. And then from 11th grade to 12th grade, students must also still have those same 3 courses and a total of 18 credits. Next slide, please.
So as they were talking before about the specifics of the curriculum, any student who has not passed Math 1 in middle school is automatically placed into Foundations of Math 1 class. Generally, the first week of school, a diagnostic test is given. And if that student passes that diagnostic test or gets a specific grade, then he or she is placed in a Math 1 class. If not, then that student would have to take the first part of their math, which is the Foundations of Math 1, and then they would take the second part, Math 1. Other information there is the 10th, 11th, and the 12th grade, and we're not going to worry about that right now because we're talking about 8th graders, so our focus is going to be that 9th grade. Next slide, please.
So this is a continuation of the math credits, and this is for any of those students who may be looking to continue into the IB program that Ms. Willett referenced. And so you'll see here, essentially the starting points are the same in 9th grade. The progression then depends upon which math you'd want to take 11th and 12th grade year. I do want to point out something that is important for students to know. If you're interested in doing IB junior and senior year, you are required to complete Math 1, 2, and 3 prior to that. So students need to have through Math 3 at the end of 10th grade year to progress into the IB DP program. Next slide.
So this is a different curriculum as we've talked about before. A student may choose his or her pathway that they want to take in the IB program. So this tells you pretty much the same thing that Ms. Dowdy just told you. It's just a different concentration. I believe, and Ms. Davis can help me if I'm saying this wrong, but I believe this has more of a calculus approach as opposed to the previous curriculum. Next slide, please.
And this is the last one in math courses. So you'll see the initial thing there is IB Math Analysis and Approaches HL. So when we talk about IB, and again, you know, we're not really planning for DP just yet, but when we talk about IB, students do have to have a certain number of what we call SL and HL, so higher level courses. And so students who are particularly strong in math would set themselves up to get an HL credit in math, and this would be the option. So you can again see with this, these students are going to come to us with pretty advanced math credits, and then they would progress up to those higher level math courses in 11th and 12th grade year. Next slide.
So as we said before, we're not going to spend a lot of time on this slide. Every student who comes into the 9th grade next year is going to have to take that economics and personal finance, regardless of what program, whether it's standard, honors, or the middle years IB program, everyone has to take that class for social studies. Next slide, please.
So here's the science sequencing chart. And so there is, you know, the 3 basic requirements, earth and environmental, biology, and then a physical science. And when we talk about the physical science requirement, that can be done through physical science by name. physics or chemistry. And really how students progress through science depends upon, you know, what they want to eventually join into junior and senior year for those science courses. So you can see most of our students will do earth and environmental exclusively ninth grade year, whether scholars or honors. Some students do choose ninth grade year to double up on earth and environmental as well as biology to get that physical science credit, then 10th grade year, which again sets them up to enter into the IB program, 11th and 12th grade year. So you can just see the sequence seen here. Most of our students, again, will go earth and environmental 9, biology 10, and then a physical science 11. And do note that we have a ton of AP science options as well for those students that don't go the IB track. There are other options that can consider with AP. Next slide.
So all students, as we said before, that we are going to be going to the middle schools beginning next week. So if you are a CMS middle school, I've already sent the registration form. So the middle school counselor actually has that form to help students to give to them so that they can go ahead and pick out their classes as well as their primary electives and their alternate electives. And we'll actually not come to the school, we'll do it virtually, but we will meet with each individual child or rising ninth grader. And then for non-CMS, we will meet with, you know, either the parents or the students on a particular day. You'll have a Zoom link and your appointment will be set up for us. So we're trying to work everything out with this registration process. On this slide is just some information that you can go and find out a little bit more about the specific curriculums to help you make the choices that you need to choose your classes. Thank you. Next slide, please.
Thank you so much. And if you're like me, I have three children two who have come through Myers Park and one who will, and I've taught at Myers Park and I'm now at AP and I'm still overwhelmed sometimes by the amount of information, but that's what makes our counselors so fantastic is you do not have to walk away tonight worried about how you're gonna make the right decisions because our counselors do help the students determine what is best for them. So last up for this evening, we are very excited to have some students joining us for a Student Government Association panel. And so joining us tonight is Brown Blanton, who plays soccer for Myers Park High School. Heidi Emanuel, unfortunately, was not able to be here this evening. Alex Hefner, who is with our soccer team and co-founder of Kicks for Kids Club. Michaela Gathers, who is president and co-founder of Myers Park High School's Black Student Union, member of the MP Theater Department and the International Thespian Society, Vice President of the Axe Club, and Charlie Robinson, who is an IB diploma candidate, runs cross country and speech and debate. So thank you so much for being here this evening. So I'm going to ask some questions, and sometimes the questions are for the whole group, and sometimes just individual ones will answer the question. So the first question this evening is, what is your fondest memory or funniest moment from your ninth grade year at Myers Park High School? And I'd love for all of you to share that with us.
I can start us off. I know my fondest memory, I was choosing between two. One was, we have several clubs that fundraise and do different things on campus. And I believe one club, as a fundraiser, the students got to duct tape Mr. Jeffers to a tree. And Mr. Jeffers is one of the assistant principals, and I just remember walking out for lunch and seeing him on the tree, and it was just like really hilarious. And then also I had a really great teacher, his name was Mr. Murphy, and he did Motivational Fridays, and he'd always bring out this drum set and he'd like hype up the class, and then we'd do like these different like team building events, and we even did like Unity Walk once. It was really great. So those are definitely my fondest memories.
My fondest memory from ninth grade was probably me going and competing in speech and debate tournaments because I'd never done that before. And that was really fun for me to go and compete against schools and represent Myers Park. And I had a great time doing that.
My best memory from freshman year was no doubt making a playoff run to the state championship, the Myers Park soccer team. Being a part of that team made the transition from middle school to high school a lot easier. And that's something I'll never forget.
My fondest memory from my ninth grade year has to be going bowling every Friday during my PE class. it was like a really great stress reliever, and it was like a great end of the week.
Thank you so much. And a couple of you actually talked about classes, so it may be a similar answer, but can you tell us what your favorite ninth grade course was and why?
My favorite course was actually theater, and I'm like a part of the theater program, as you see, and it's just really fun because it's a great community of students, and also Miss Roberts, our director, is a really great director, and it actually inspired me to be a part of the MP theater program, like just being in the class. So I definitely, if you're interested in that, if you want to just do that type of thing, definitely reach out and do that.
My favorite class in ninth grade was probably biology. I enjoyed that class a lot with my teacher, Miss Simmons, and I had a great time in there, and she challenged me, and we got to learn new things that I really had never seen before.
My favorite class freshman year was an elective that I took, sports entertainment marketing. And I remember I got to go on a field trip uptown with my class and learn about different workforces in North Carolina. It was really interesting.
My favorite ninth grade course was math too with Mr. Dunn, because he was a great teacher, but the best thing about that class was he made like learning fun. And that was just why it was my favorite class.
I love hearing that as a former math teacher. Thank you for giving a shout out for the math classes. So my next question to you would be, is there anything that you would do differently from your ninth grade year? And if so, why?
I think I'd personally take more advantage of the different things we have on campus when it comes to like band concerts, theater productions, football games, just any sports events, because right now in COVID, those are the things I'm really missing. Because I mean, it would be like, you know, really fun after a long week going to a football game on Friday. I'd even invite like friends from other schools because we have like the best football game environment, things like that. So when those things open back up, definitely take advantage of those.
I would have liked to have tried to join more clubs and organizations at the school. You know, I kind of found what I was interested in and kind of delve into that pretty deep, pretty quick. But I wish that I would have taken the time to maybe go to a few first meetings at a few other clubs and see what they had to offer, because I'm sure that they're all great and they all could offer you a lot.
Something that has proven to be really beneficial for me this year has been keeping an agenda. And I wish freshman year I had done that, because my stress levels probably would not have been as high and I would have been able to be more organized.
For me, looking back to ninth grade, kind of like Charlie, I wish I didn't join so many clubs. I wish I like stuck to like two or three more clubs, because I like, there was a day when like all the clubs, you got to choose like what you wanted to take. And I chose like 10 or 15 different, like it was like a big number and it was a really big mistake. And I wish I just picked like two or three clubs and got really involved in those particular clubs.
Thank you so much. So tell them a little bit about what would be in your book bag if you're on campus, like if you're back into normal on campus, what would be in your book bag and what do you keep in your locker?
I don't use a locker, and so I know my friends who take band, if you're worried about having like a lot of stuff, if you take a sport, usually the coaches let you drop off your bags and stuff in their offices. Or I know if you take band, your instrument can drop off into like the band room. But what I always carry, I know I'll say an umbrella is key, because when it rains on campus, you're gonna really want an umbrella, especially since we're outside. Yeah, so just keep one in your book bag at all times, even if it says it's going to be sunny. That's like helped me a lot.
I would recommend bringing more writing utensils than you think you'll need. I always found myself short on those. And so I would recommend bringing a lot of those. Make sure that you have an organized system for all your classes where you can put your work for each of them.
Two things I try not to forget in my backpack are usually earbuds, because I feel like in some courses, especially like engineering electives and computer-based courses, you're going to need headphones a lot. And then I usually try to bring like a snack. I know that sounds kind of funny, but I usually try to bring like a granola bar or a banana just to keep like my energy high during the day, get as much work done as possible.
For me, I made a mistake freshman year and I wouldn't switch out my A day and B day supplies each day. So I started having back problems because my backpack was way too heavy. So a little bit of advice, I would switch out your A day and B day supplies each day. It's really beneficial.
Thank you for that helpful information. I do know that our students on our campus don't use lockers. So as a result of that, you guys have some pretty full book bags sometimes, and then may even be carrying an additional bag in your hand. So thank you. Next question. So our campus is pretty big. It's a long way from the gym all the way back to the mobile classrooms during a normal, like in-person kind of a situation. Tell us how transitions look on our campus. Do you have enough time? Do you feel like you're late? Do you get in trouble if you're late? So tell us a little bit about that.
It's definitely funny that you mentioned that, because my freshman year, I did have to travel from the gym to the mobile classrooms within, we have 7 minutes to transition. And I will say it is doable. Some days you may have to hustle, but it is definitely doable.
The transitions between classes, it's the first bell rings and you have 7 minutes to get from your class to the next class. And then a minute before you're late, the late bell will ring. And so that's like more of like an alarm. And so, you know, if you hear that, you know, you got to start hustling if you're far away. But I wouldn't really worry about being late. I mean, at the gym to the mobile classrooms, you might have to hustle. That's about the farthest one.
I actually never have had a problem with the 7 minute time constraint. I find it pretty easy normally get to classes, and I normally have enough time to say hi to some of my friends that I see in the quad or walk in different buildings.
For me, I had a little bit of an issue traveling from the gym to the mobile classroom last year, but my teacher I had was really nice about it, and he knew it was a long travel. So he let me in every day if I was 5 seconds late. It was really nice. So a lot of teachers are really like that. So you'll be fine.
Thank you. So next question that I have for you, thinking back to middle school, are lunches at high school different from lunches in middle school as far as the structure and everything goes? And do you have any recommendation for students is based on that for our particular lunches on our campus?
I definitely think there is a difference. I know I was kind of shocked my first day on like ninth grade when I had to go to lunch. But it's really easy, just like, you know, find a place to sit with, like maybe you find somebody you're in the same class with, because lunches happen during third block. So you can walk there together and maybe you want to meet up with some friends. It's like, you know, it seems kind of hectic at first, but you can figure it out.
Thank you. And one thing that Michaela pointed out, which is very important, is we actually have 5 lunches on our campus. So when she was discussing the fact that you would go based on your third, it's also based on what classrooms you're in during third block. So that part of it is a little bit different as well with the 5 different lunches and the groups going. So I know in a previous panel, they mentioned the importance of making some new friends as well, since you may not have lunches with the same people. Next question that I have for you. A few of you guys have already talked a little bit about the extracurricular activities, making sure that you get involved in enough, but not over get involved. What suggestions do you have for getting involved in extracurricular activities and also in sports for those of you that play sports?
I made a note to make sure to mention that if you are trying out for a sport, especially a fall sport, workouts happen during the summer, so don't be afraid to reach out to the coaches. Like, you can find them on the Myers Park website and reach out. And then also, just when it comes to extracurriculars, I think you should find what you're passionate about. If you're passionate about social justice, we have a lot of social justice clubs. If you're passionate about, I don't know, French, we have even like French club, different things like that.
For me, I play in the soccer team. And last year, I got in contact with upperclassmen, but if I didn't know any upperclassmen or anyone you may know on the extracurricular activity, I would say just get in contact with the coach. All coaches at Myers Park would love to hear that you have interest in their sport.
Similar to what Brown said, it really helped me freshman year, just communicating with upperclassmen. My ride to school freshman year was already on the soccer team. So it was like helpful. Like he helped me get in contact with the coach. He gave me advice for my SGA application, and he kind of gave me the confidence to start my own club.
And if you're interested in like a club or a different organization besides sports, you can reach out to the club's advisor over the summer and they can tell you about it. Or at the beginning of the year, there's a Mustang Stampede, which is where all the clubs come out and introduce what they are. And so that's a good chance to find clubs you might be interested in.
Thank you so much. And I do want to commend our SGA because they have been doing a fantastic job this year of trying to keep clubs going and trying to keep virtual opportunities going for our students. Even the Stampede, which would have been a great opportunity to get involved in the beginning of the school year by going out into the quad, they found a way to get students involved through a virtual introduction of clubs. So thank you so much for making that opportunity available. Next question. So earlier in the evening, we talked about the different kinds of pathways that you can take. You can do scholars courses, honors courses, APs, NYPs, IBs. Can you tell us a little bit about which pathway that you chose and why you chose that particular pathway?
Coming straight out of middle school, I chose the NYP IB route, and then now I'm in the IB diploma program. And so I came from an IB middle school, so it kind of made sense for me to continue. But I also feel like if you didn't come from an IB middle school, you should definitely check out the IB program. And what I like about it, it's very project-based. When you learn, you're able to learn about things that you're interested in. And then I also think that one big part of the IB diploma, since it's international, it's a big, like, you have to learn about global issues, global context, and you kind of find you relating your learning to the world around you. And I really enjoy that aspect about it.
When I was deciding which pathway to take, I kind of just looked at all the courses as a whole, like how my progression would be through the entirety of the 4 years of high school. And I ended up choosing the MYP IB program as well. I just found it as a program that allowed me to express my creativity better than the other programs. And I looked down the road, saw the courses I'd be taking junior and senior year. And I thought that was a challenge I wanted to set for myself.
Thank you. So my next question to you is, can you tell us a little bit, if you are having trouble academically, what are some suggestions that you have for a student?
I will just name one. We have an amazing tutoring program on campus between different clubs. I know just like science, honor society, they tutor in science. Like there's always a tutoring program for any subject.
I would say just talk to the teacher. You know, usually the teacher will know, you know, what you're struggling in or what you may need help with. And if you just take the time to meet with the teacher during their office hours, you know, it'll be really beneficial and they can help you a lot on that.
To add on to Michaela, I think every single class I've took this year, the teachers offered tutoring sessions after school. So I really would recommend taking them. They are free and they're very helpful. So it's very beneficial for your learning.
For any student that is struggling academically, I think the most important thing is just setting your priorities. I think time management is a really important component to academic success, and being able to manage your time is going to help you all 4 years of high school and in the future.
Thank you. And one thing that I really love about the responses that you all had was the ownership that you guys take in that. So you look for tutoring opportunities and you talk with the teachers and you look for ways to be successful. And that's one thing that we really hope our high school students will develop over that time, is the way to take the ownership and things like that. So thank you. So tell us, what's one last parting word that you would have for the incoming ninth graders?
I'll just start off, like, just following what you said, self-advocacy is really, really important. I also say find your support system on campus, teachers, friends, just different staff members, admin. I'm going to shout out Ms. Kendall, who's on this call. She spoke earlier. She's my support system. We have great, yeah, just reach out.
I would say, just like Michaela kind of said, be an advocate for yourself. You know, Myers Park's a big school and each student needs to find their place. And being an advocate for yourself will end up helping you in the long run.
For a lot of people, I think high school can be a pressure in your life, but I think the best way to take on high school is to view it as an opportunity. If you just immerse yourself in working hard and becoming a better version of yourself, high school is going to fly by and you're not going to have to worry about it.
I would say be yourself and don't be scared to try new things because that's what high school is all about.
Thank you. So again, once again, I would like to say thank you to Brown, Alex, Michaela, and Charlie for being here this evening and sharing this information with us. And I would just like to thank everybody for joining us this evening for this event. If you still have curriculum questions, again, I'm Allison Davis. I'm the Assistant Principal of Instruction. And my contact email is kathryn.davis@cms.k12.nc.us. And again, please feel free to visit our website. We have a lot of great information there on the website. So we wish everybody a great evening. Thank you.